Hi friends, in this video we'll discuss about the error acoustic modeling on a side mirror. So there are two approaches in ANSYS Fluent. One of them is a broadband noise model and the other one is a Fox William Hawking model. So first we'll discuss about the broadband noise model, how to implement that and what are the advantages and disadvantages compared to the other model. So I'll just show you the model what I'm selecting in the present simulation. So you can see here, this is the mirror and this is the inlet from which air is getting entered, and this face is wall I have considered, and remaining all other faces I have considered as an opening which air can go out. So when air comes and sticks or stucks onto this mirror, it will try to create sound pressure waves or sound signals, and how that sound waves are been created and how it is been imposed and all these things we'll just see in the tutorial. And basically in the broadband spectrum model, broadband noise model, so this is the pressure of the sound that would be calculated by the tool or the software on the source what we have considered. So here if you consider the mirror as a source of the sound, so it tries to calculate only the value of the sound pressure on the mirror itself, not on any part of the domain or any other point in the domain. It just calculates only on the source. So it will try to show us what is the distribution of the sound pressure wave or the intensity only on the mirror or the source. So that is a disadvantage because we cannot calculate anywhere else within the domain how the sound pressure is getting distributed within the domain and far field, I mean like very away from the source. So those cannot be calculated using the broadband noise model. So it will just only calculate the sound intensity on the source. So how it calculate is in using this formula. So there's a pressure distribution or the pressure of the sound. So it is which is a function of the velocity scale and length scale. As we know, for velocity and length scale, if you can go for the turbulence model, velocity and length scale are directly correlated to k and epsilon or k and omega model. So in this present scenario, I'm considering k epsilon. So this formula can be finally treated in this way, where it has a terms of epsilon and mt is a function depending on the k. So it is a turbulence intensity, turbulent dissipation as well as turbulent creation k. So those things would be added into this sound signal or sound pressure distribution on the source. So finally we can say that k and epsilon are the terms which need to be calculated on the mirror surface in order to predict the sound generation or the sound noise generation on the mirror. So this k and epsilon we know that we can calculate from the Navier-Stokes equation along with the turbulence equation in order to find those values of k and epsilon at each and every point of the discretized domain. So those values of k and epsilon are used in this calculation of the sound pressure wave on the surface of the window or surface of the side mirror. And this is the decibels, sound decibel value, which has been calculated by using just a log formula, which is PA by PREF. PREF is the reference pressure what we'll consider. Generally there would be a default reference pressure, and you can change the default reference pressure if you want to have according to your own requirement. So this is the broadband noise model. So in the broadband noise model, we will just try to simulate the normal flow without any acoustics model highlighted. And after the completion of the entire model, we will just now go to the broadband noise model and we'll tick the model and we'll just try to post-process the things. That's it. So here there is no other any equation would be solved simultaneously along with the governing equations of fluid dynamics. So it will not solve any other equations, but finally after all the equations of the fluids are solved, we'll just try to interpret it or we'll execute this formula and we'll try to find the intensity of the sound on the side mirror. So I'll just show you the setup. So this is my setup. I'll go for a transient simulation. And just I'll go for models. So I'll just select epsilon realizable scalable wall function. We'll click on OK. By default it is air, so I'll leave that as air only, and I'll just go to the inlet condition. In the inlet velocity inlet, I would give 10 as my velocity magnitude. I'll just click OK. So mirror wall and these walls are okay, but opening is a pressure opening, so I'll just click on opening, and I'll give outflow condition where the fluid or the air can just go normally outside it. So click OK, and after this I'll just initialize. I'll go with the hybrid initialization. So after hybrid initialization, I'll just go to run calculation, and I'll go to time step size. Maybe I'll select 0.001 and number of time steps. So it's just for a tutorial purpose. You can have your own time steps and all those things depending on the current number, global current number. So it will take some time. So I have ran few time steps. Now we'll try to check out the counters, how the pressure counters are present on the mirror wall. So you can see the pressure counters. So here it is high on the level because the air is coming and stagnating here, so the pressure is high, and obviously it would be low on the other side of the mirror. We'll try to select one plane and we'll check how the pressure has been distributed on that plane. So now you can check here. So the pressure is hitting high on the other side of the mirror and low on the rear side. So that is obvious. And now we'll try to check how the formula that have shown previously, so this formula, how it is being executed, so in which is in terms of turbulence, kinetic energy and turbulence dissipation. I'll just show you the flow in manam. So now we'll check how the acoustic pressure has been distributed, which is indirectly a level of indication of sound that has been generated due to that source. Just go to broadband noise model. So I have previously said the acoustic reference pressure. So this is the acoustic reference power, which is 1e⁻¹². You can change according to your requirement. So and the values of far field sound speed, everything I have left default, which is obviously those values will not change in our simulation. So click on apply. Okay, now just go back to the counters again. Now you can see here acoustics. In this I have checked acoustic power level dB compute, so you can see here. So the areas which are contributing to the acoustic power or sound indirectly, so it is indicated in terms of dB, decibels. So maximum is 71.68 and the minimum is 0, obviously it would be 0, and there is a areas where it is touching 7.17 also. You can see here, we can check how these things have been just calculated using the simple formulae. So this is the formula how it will been calculated. So it will not solve any differential equations or any sort of stuff to find the distribution around the within the domain, but which we can use a Fox-William-Hawking model in order to calculate the distribution of that pressure wave or sound signal far away from the source also, how it is getting distributed. So we'll check that in our next video. So please find the next video in the below description. So I request you all to subscribe the channel and encourage me for doing more number of videos. Thank you.